Hello, everyone.
Sydney Mfundagcaba, the man the state claims paid the suspects in the murder of the rapper Kenan Forbes, aka, comes from a notorious family with a taxi business empire known for intimidating its rivals and allegedly buying weapons from the police. A 2022 report by a global initiative called Strategic Organized Crime South Africa, which referred to the Gcaba family as the Taxi Johns of Durban, also known as the Gcaba brothers. The family are the most feared in the taxi industry in KwaZulu-Natal and beyond. The family is also said to be untouchable, that they even threatened a former transport MEC in the province. The family hails from Gandla, and the brothers' mother is sister to former President Jacob Zuma. The state prosecutor on Wednesday, Advocate Elvis Gcweka, told the Durban Magistrates Court that Musi Wethemba Heavy Gwabeni, who is said to be the coordinator of the hit on AKA, received more than 800,000 rand a day after the murder from a bank account owned by Gcaba's company, Bright Circle. Gwabeni then allegedly split the money among his co-accused. AKA and his friend Debelo Tips Motsoane were killed outside Wish Restaurant on Florida Road, Durban, on Friday on 10 February last year. According to a company register search done by Sowetan, Gcaba is a director of 7 other companies that are involved in agriculture, logistics and taxi business. He started Bright Circle in 2017, and the company is based in Umhlanga, a resort town from north of Durban. There are no details of what services it does, but also it does not have any online presence. According to the Global Initiative report, Gcaba is one of 4 brothers who took over their father's taxi business in 1996 after his murder. The other brothers are Mandla, Roma and Thembinkosi. They are arguably the most feared family in the KwaZulu-Natal taxi industry and have a reputation countrywide as the dons of the multi-billion rand industry. According to one taxi boss interviewed, they controlled everything in taxis. They are untouchable. One police officer interviewed claimed that the Gcabas even threatened KwaZulu-Natal MEC for transport at the time, Xolisi Kaunda, now Durban mayor, and told him they can have him removed from office. The report further said that they created links at different levels of the police, and brothers have since expanded this corrupt relationship to a point where police officer Chris Prince Lou confessed at 2019 inquiry into taxi industry violence that he had sold guns to Gcabas and other rivals in KwaZulu-Natal. The report said the Gcabas were among the first taxi bosses to hire private security to protect both the family and their lucrative taxi business interest. In the late 1990s, they hired the taxi violence unit, but it was not long before they realized that it would be more lucrative and effective to establish their own private security companies. The Gcabas have subsequently been accused of forcing other taxi bosses and associations to make use of Gcaba-run privately security companies. Back in 2015, Sydney Gcaba was among 11 men who were charged with the murder of 3 people following a shooting at Brook Street taxi rank. They were acquitted in 2017 because of poor evidence. During his bail application, Gcaba told the court that he was a father of 8 children and engaged to 3 women. He also said he had 24 taxes and earned 400,000 rand monthly. Meanwhile, Gwabeni appeared in court on Wednesday with his co-accused Lindani Ndimande, Lindokuhle Ndimande, Siyanda Myeza, and Lindokuhle Mkhwanazi. They are facing 10 charges, including 2 counts of murder, 5 of attempted murder, conspiracy to commit murder, possession of unlawful firearms, and possession of unlawful ammunition. 2 other accused, brothers Siyabonga Gezani Ndimande and Malus Dave Ndimande, who were arrested in Eswatini last month, are being extradited to South Africa. The state is opposing their bail application. Kumarasan Pillay made the allegation in the affidavit read out by Gcweka that Gwabeni's bank records showed that a day after the murder, At about 2 p.m., he received more than 800,000 rand. He said Gwabeni's cell phone record show he made a call to a number linked to Gqaba. Shortly after this call, more than 803,000 rand was transferred to Gwabeni's bank account. The affidavit said, when the money was transferred, a reference was used as consult. This, we are of the view, was done to disguise the nature of the funds, as same is viewed to be payment for the shooting. His team is investigating the source of this and other funds that may have been used for planning and execution of the offences. When Gwabeni transferred money, he used the reference dividends. Company records do not indicate that any of the co-accused were shareholders in any of his companies. Therefore, they were not entitled to any dividends. People also reacted after Mfundo Gqaba was fingered in the AKA's murder case. They took it to the ex-app and one said, the Gqaba brothers are known here in KZN as the killing family. It's no surprise that the money was trail points to one of them. Remember when 11 people were killed in this taxi? Who was behind it? You guessed right. Another one said, we are being threatened for seeking justice for AKA to the point of people even telling us they will find us. I mean, why do KZN peeps have to be like this? Yini le engaka, no one is ever above the law. Justice will prevail. Another one said, the hit on AKA was obviously more than 800k. I don't think the Gqaba brothers will just order a hit on AKA for no reason. Someone must have contacted them for assistance, which they provided and probably compensated on besides the 800k. Hashtag justice for AKA. Someone also said, those Gqaba guys think they own the world, I swear. They killed people in a club few years ago in front of patrons. They also beat up their brother-in-law when they found him in a club with girls. Kodwanai. Another one said, dear AKA, you were taken out by the most powerful families in KZN. The Dembe and the Gqabas are allegedly involved. Fight for your justice in that grave. State officials may be bought at any time. Fight until you get that justice. Others are alleging that AKA's friends know something about this. Someone also tweeted, the NPA needs to check if there were any payments made from Sifundo Gqaba to any of the AKA's friends. There's a lot of missing information on how the killers knew the flights, cars, people, number of bodyguards and exact travel times from Bryanston to OR Tambo to King Shaka. Hashtag justice for AKA. Another one alleged that the Dembe family and the Gqabas are longtime friends and tweeted and said, it's becoming clear now that the Dembes might be the mastermind behind the death of AKA. The Gqabas and the Dembes are longtime friends. Gqaba brothers had no motive to kill AKA, but the Dembes had. My take, the Dembes requested the services of the Gqabas. What's your take on this one, people? Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more news.